Hi teachers, today I'm going to be demonstrating the missing number task. My demonstration is based on how it would unfold in the classroom. Class, today I have a pot with 7 cubes in here. How many cubes do I have? 7. I need to add some cubes in my pot. I now have 12 cubes in this pot. How many cubes do I have? 12. How many cubes do you think I've added in my pot? And how would we work this out? So I want to think about this and show it to you as a number sentence. I started with 7 cubes. I've added some more cubes. And I'm now left with 12 cubes in my pot. I'm going to show you how this would look on a number line. So here's my number line starting at 0. I had 7 cubes in my pot, which I started off with. I added some more. We don't know how many I've put into the pot, but what we do know is that we had 12 altogether. So now I need to find out how to get from 7 to 12. One way of doing it is to say 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. But that's very long, and we don't want to be counting on our fingers. So I want to chug through 10. And for me to do that, I need to add 3. Which gives me 10. And I need 2 more to get to 12. So 3 and 2 together make 5. As you can see here, a jump of 3 and a jump of 2 is the same as a jump of 5. Which means that 7 plus 5 equals 12. I wanted to know, how do I get to 12? Instead of me counting on from 7, I've decided to jump through 10. So I said 7 plus 3 is 10, plus a jump of 2 to get to 12. Together, a jump of 3 and a jump of 2 makes 5. Therefore, I've added 5 cubes to my pot to get to 12 cubes, which are in here. So teachers, to discourage children from counting in ones, we want them to make a 10 and add on from there. Thank you.